Hello, this is David, Principal Engineer at Dell, and in this video I'll be covering performing a non-authoritative sync, also known as a non-authoritative restore, of SYSVOL data using FRS, or the File Replication Service. And you might be thinking, FRS, isn't that hopelessly obsolete? And yes, it has been deprecated in favor of DFSR, but it does still exist in domains that have been around for a while and have never been migrated to DFSR. And this AD environment that we'll be working here is a very simple environment consisting of two domain controllers running Windows Server 2016, named DC1 and DC2, and FRS on DC1 is currently broken, as we're about to see. Now, if we open Group Policy Management on DC1, you can see we have 8 GPOs there. And if we look through some of these GPOs, we'll get this error. The system cannot find the file specified on several of the GPOs. And that's a pretty good clue that something's wrong with SYSVOL. The GPOs exist in Active Directory. Both DCs can see them, but the template files don't exist on both DCs. And that's because of a SYSVOL replication failure. We can confirm the missing template files by going to File Explorer and browsing to Windows SYSVOL Domain Policies. And you'll see in there several folders, in this case 5 folders, and each of those folders has a GUID as its name. Now, if we go back to Group Policy Management and look through our GPOs here, with the GPO selected, if we look at the Details tab in the main pane, you'll see that the GUIDs of the folders in the SYSVOL folder correspond to the GUIDs of the GPOs. Each of those folders contains the template files for that particular GPO. And incidentally, the default domain controller policy GUID is always going to be the one that begins with 6AC1, and the default domain policy GUID is always going to begin with 31B2. Those won't ever change. But as we can see, we've got 5 GPOs. 5 folders in the policies folder and 8 GPOs. And the missing ones, if we scroll through each one, we'll see that the missing ones, the ones returning the errors, have GUIDs that are missing from that folder there. So those are the ones with the missing template files, which we already knew, but this just proves it. So now we need to open Event Viewer and look in the FRS event log. And it shows here that we have new events available, so we'll refresh. And if we check here, we see event 13555, an error event indicating that FRS is in an error state. Now, since I artificially broke FRS, you may see different errors. Just know that you're looking for some sort of error message indicating that FRS isn't functioning correctly. And obviously, that's what we've got here. So what we're going to need to do, because this isn't working right, we'll need to check the SYSVOL policies folder on our other DC and see how it compares to this one. So in this case, our other DC is DC2. So we browse to it in File Explorer, and we see here its policies folder contains 8 GP templates. Folders, whereas the one on DC1 only contains 5, as we've already established. So this means, since we've got 8 GPOs, we've already established that as well, their template files are all present on DC2. So we need to copy those files from DC2 over to DC1. We don't want to just manually copy and paste, though. That will not help get FRS back to a working state, but there is a procedure that will force DC1 to copy them from DC2. And that procedure involves just a little bit of registry modification. And in order to kick that off, we go to Regedit and browse to HKLM, System, Current Control Set, Services, NtFrs, Parameters, /restore, Process at Startup. And you'll see a DWORD value in there called BR flags. I believe that's short for Backup Restore flags. And it's currently set to 0. It is normally set to 0. Before we change it, we want to stop the file replication service on DC1. Wait a second for it to stop. Wait a few more seconds for it to stop. And it has stopped, so we can go back to the registry and set BR flags to hexadecimal value of D2. That signifies a non-authoritative sync. And you see that corresponds to a decimal value of 210. You can set it that way too, but I think everybody uses the hex value. Once we've done that, we start file replication service from the services console. And it starts up pretty quickly. After it starts, we can go back to Regedit refresh, and you'll see that burr flags has reset itself to 0. So now we go back to our event log, and you'll see there are new events here. So we refresh the log, and we can browse through the new events since that last error. It shows it's stopping, has stopped, starting, and then there's a number of warning events. File replication service is deprecated. We knew that already. Ignore that write cache error. It says it's initializing the system volume with data from another domain controller. That's exactly what we want it to do. That's what a non-authoritative sync is. And you'll notice it says cannot become a domain controller until the process completes. And then we get this event here saying that pre-existing data has been moved to another folder. We'll look at that further in another video. For now, just note that that's normal. And we get this event saying it successfully added it to the replica set, the SYSVOL set, and successfully added the connections to the replica set. Scroll down, inbound from DC2, outbound to DC2. Since it's our only other DC, that's expected. And you can see we've got new events again. Refresh, and this is the one we're looking for. Informational event 13516. Basically, it's our all good event. Says it's no longer preventing the computer from becoming a domain controller. System volume has been successfully initialized, and that logon service has been notified that it's ready. Type net share to check for the SYSVOL share. We'll do that right now from a command prompt. And you'll see we do have SYSVOL and net logon in the output. That's what we were hoping to see. If we go back to our policies folder, we can now see there are 8 items there. All of the group policy template folders have replicated. Bring up the policies folder on DC2, and we see that they do indeed match. That indicates that the non-authoritative sync was successful, and both DCs now have the same SYSVOL data in both of their folders. Once again, this is David, principal engineer at Dell, and thank you for watching.